Hello, I'm Damon, Mercy Solutions. Today we're going to take a look at an optical jukebox. We'll first of all go and have a look at the jukebox in the lab, and then we'll come back and have a look how that appears when connected to the computer through the software. So if we go through to the lab, we'll take a look at the jukebox. Today we're going to take a look at an optical jukebox. What we have here is a Netzon jukebox. It actually holds 105 discs. So if we start at the top here, we've actually got a male slot for taking discs in and out of the jukebox. If I open the door on the jukebox, you can see inside we've got three magazines. If I click one of these magazines, just take a look. If I unlock the magazine, you'll be able to see there's 35 trays, and in each tray holds an individual disc. Again, the magazine locks, and when locked, the discs can no longer fall out. So I'll just place this back into the jukebox and lock that in place. Okay. So if we move to the side of the jukebox here, what we should do is remove the side panel on this one and give an overview of what's going on inside. So again, three magazines. In the middle here, we have robotics. And at the top, we can have up to four drives. So the four drives can all be read to and written to at the same time. And again, the robotics move the discs from the various slots here into the drives. So if we move over to a computer now, we'll take a closer look.
Okay, so I'm now connected to the actual jukebox system. And what I'll also do is just bring in a background picture of the actual jukebox robotics, so we can see how they correspond. So what we have here on the actual desktop of the machine the jukebox is attached to is the administration tool for the jukebox management software. The jukebox management software can be thought of as a driver that turns the actual jukebox into a big disk drive. So we can see here, clicking on the actual jukebox device, you can see we've got multiple slots listed in the magazines they correspond within. If I actually expand this out under the explorer here, we have the name of the computer and then devices attached. So in this case, we've got the jukebox, and inside the jukebox we've got three magazines. So we can actually click into a magazine. You can see here in the first magazine we've got slot one. It's got a disc called YouTube demo and a disc called backup one, and two blank 128 gig discs. Underneath this we've then got the drives. So this jukebox can have up to four drives. I've got two in here, but one of them I've disabled. The reason I've disabled that is so we can actually get some more robotics movements rather than just having the discs sat within a single drive. So if we go to this PC, we can see on the computer we've actually got drive Z. Now drive Z is a virtual drive letter. If I open this, and in here we can see every disc in the jukebox is represented by a folder. Now we actually have a collection of some discs called volume sets. So let's click on this volume set here, Damon. You can see it actually corresponds to three discs, and those three discs are then concatenated into one folder called Damon, and the various folders are underneath there. Okay, so what happens if I actually go in and access some data? So under the YouTube demo, I've got a folder here and a couple of pictures. And if I then copy a picture over to the desktop, what we'll see is the actual request will go through. And we can actually see the jukebox. It's first of all going to put away a disk that's already in the drive. You see the robotics move there. It's back into a tray. It's now going to actually grab the disk YouTube demo and load that into the drive. You can see that's just inserted now. It'll take it a few seconds from the drive to actually spin the disk up, read the table of contents of the disk, and then we'll get the files actually transferred over to the desktop. And for the purpose of the demonstration, I've got a lot of the caching disabled, which we'll actually have a look at in a slightly deeper dive, where we can actually set up these files actually existing on disk. So there we can see that file is actually copied across. If I subsequently access a file or a couple of files from here and copy them to the desktop, you'll see they're copied over virtually instantly. You see they're both there, one's been in the background. The reason for that is they're obviously already loaded in the drive and the drive's ready. Okay, so coming back to the actual jukebox here, we can see if I do a properties on the disk, the disk has actually only got a couple of megabytes on it and it's got 115 gigabytes free. And the reason for this is the disk is actually read-writable. So I can actually, on drive Z, into YouTube demo, I can actually just copy my entire demo folder straight here into the jukebox. And these files are now in a write cache, waiting to be written to the disk. And again, we can see this again on the software here. I bring this up, I've got 20 megabytes waiting to be written. I can actually tell this to flush the write cache. Normally the way this software would be configured is that we would set up two buffers, both a read cache and a write cache. Write cache being data that's waiting to be written to a disk, and then a read cache, data that has been read back from a disk or to be read back. The idea with the two caches is that the system can be configured that the day-to-day reading and access of data actually is served from a hard disk or NVMe drive or SSD at the speed of that actual particular drive. Okay, so we can see that is actually completed now. All of that data is written. So again, if we come back here and we just have a quick properties on the drive, you see it's actually 22 megabytes of data there now. So if I tell the jukebox to actually rescan this disk here, it will cause it to unload the actual drive. You can see here the actual robot's going to first unload the drive, the actual disk, and pop this away. Then load the next disk. Okay, if I come back here to the actual YouTube demo folder, if I go into the demo files, what I can actually do is click on some of these, and this will actually cause the jukebox to request a file. As you can see again, it's going to actually go and load the disk, and the full data will then be served back. What we've actually got being displayed at the moment is a preview from the thumbnails DB that Windows has got cached. Again, give it a couple of seconds. See the actual jukebox drive activity flashing there. And it's going to transfer the data. And we should see the picture appear properly. Okay, there we go. Again, if I actually open up a different picture, we'll see again this is virtually instant again because the disk is loaded. Again, if I go through to the gold pictures, the same again, they're served directly from the disk and I can scroll through from there. So obviously the main benefit of this system is it's worm media, it's optical, which means once the data is written it cannot be deleted. So again, if I come back here under YouTube demo, And if I say to actually delete this, say yes. And I'm just going to ask for admin, say continue. And it's not allowing me to actually do this because it's not physically possible, because it is write once. Okay. Thank you very much.